Technology is evolving at an unprecedented speed, and staying competitive means being able to adapt at the same speed as technology in the most efficient, agile, and cost-effective ways. Here to discuss telecom's adoption of cloud-native technology is Ravi Kalyanakkode, Principal Telco Solutions Architect in Telecom Systems Business at Dell Technologies. Welcome, Ravi. So firstly, what impact does Dell Telecom infrastructure blocks have on an operator's network deployment?
Thank you, Clarence. Glad to be here. As customers, telco operators are going through a transformation from a vertically integrated stack to an open, disaggregated, open RAN, virtual RAN network. There are two challenges that comes to mind. The first challenge really is integration challenge. Open, disaggregated RAN network includes multiple components. There's hardware, there is cloud platform, there is RAN DUCU components, orchestration, management layers. All of these things need to be integrated. What was previously done by a single vendor from the vertical stack needs to be done by either the operator or system integrator. Now, the second challenge is Open RAN brings up a large number of tens of thousands of nodes, edge nodes, which are geographically spread out. Without having a good automation environment, providing zero-touch provisioning, upgrades in the network, automated, it is just not possible to launch such a network. To address these challenges, we have built Dell infrastructure blocks working with our partners, Intel and Winterware. The solution comprises of Dell hardware, which is PowerEdge XR11 and PowerEdge XR8000, tightly integrated with Wind River Cloud Platform, which provides a low latency distributed cloud platform to address and optimized for RAN deployments. And then the automation software, which Dell builds, called Infra Automation and Wind River's Conductor, to create an pre-integrated engineered solution. If you really look at a network operator's network deployment of a RAN network, there are, at a high level, four phases. The first phase is technology onboarding, in which customers bring in the different components and then do the integration. How Dell Telecom infrastructure block helps in this phase really is we do the integration and testing beforehand using shift left methodology. Dell's solution engineering team does the integration and runs through validation tests, integrating the cloud platform and hardware component in our labs, so the customer do not need to do that again as part of the technology onboarding. The second stage is pre-production, in which customers build out MOPs and scripts that they need to launch in their production network. The way infrastructure blocks helps is we have built automation scripts and blueprints for deployment. We provide that to the customer and customize it for the customer's deployment environment. The third stage is production. Like I said previously, an important criteria in production is to automatically roll out the complete RAN network using zero-touch provisioning principles. We provide blueprints and automated deployment using zero-touch provisioning as part of our solution. The fourth stage is managing this network from an operational perspective, data operational perspective. In that stage, what we provide is we do continuous engineering with Wind River and Intel, and then provide our software integrated at regular cadence to the customer, which the customer can use to launch. The second part is we provide operational upgrades and grids across BIOS, firmware, cloud platform in a very automated manner, which alleviates the pain to keep the network in the most updated form for the customer and helps them reduce the operational expenses.
Now, I understand that Dell has built a TCO model and performed an analysis on Open RAN deployments. Can you explain that analysis?
Sure. Very good question, Clarence. As customers are validating their Open RAN, vRAN deployments with multiple POCs and trials, the next real stage that the customer needs to work on is building a TCO model to figure out whether the solution can be deployed in a commercially viable manner in the network. So to address that, what we did is we worked with a reputed analyst company called ACG Research and built a TCO model. The way the TCO model really works is you provide inputs for deploying an Open RAN vRAN network, typical information like network deployment characteristics, how many DU nodes, how many CU nodes are really required, what are the radio carriers that needs to be deployed, how many data centers, and from an operational perspective, if there are any specific rates or labor rates which are needed to manage it from an operational perspective. Using that input, the TCO tool builds out the complete network based on the dimension, number of servers that needs to be deployed, how many data centers need to be deployed. And from an operational perspective, there are close to 20 tasks across day zero, day one, and day two that the tool has manages, categorized. And it comes up with an operational cost for managing this network. The way we build out the analysis from this point is we take two scenarios. One is if the network deployment is done using infrastructure block. The other one is if the customer goes without an infrastructure block. We compare these two scenarios and come up with an analysis for the customer on what are the benefits of deploying with infrastructure blocks.
So what are the findings of your analysis?
Absolutely, a great question. We've been working on this analysis and we have modeled different types of networks and we in fact released multiple white papers on this. I'll explain the latest one which we did. We modeled a typical mid-sized tier one telecom network for the RAN use case, approximately 50,000 cell site nodes, of which 25,000 distributed RAN type nodes where DUs are running on the cell site, and 25,000 nodes were in a centralized RAN deployment with the DU nodes running on a far edge type of a node, equivalent number of CUs. The other thing that we wanted to add to this input is addition of new technology, bringing in introduction of a new technology and how infrastructure blocks. In order to do that, Intel has released Xeon Scalable fourth generation processor with vRAN boost. We modeled the network such that after a few months of deploying the third generation Xeon Scalable processor using XR11, Dell XR11s, we introduced Dell PowerEdge XR8000, which is based on the fourth generation Intel processor. We wanted to see what are the timing advantages, what is the TCO advantage out of this. The final analysis that came out is the overall TCO savings came out to be 10% at the end of 5 years. There was a CapEx reduction. This was primarily because of the introduction of the fourth generation processor, which is significantly better performing than the third generation processor. And in addition, because of the engineered system, the number of faults, performance in the network and day two provisioning, as well as the initial automation was reduced, which resulted in about 14% OpEx savings over 5 years. One significant thing that we also noticed as part of this analysis is introduction of new technology took about 6 months lesser than what would happen without an infra block. So that also contributed to the CapEx savings as well as OpEx savings as the number of servers got reduced earlier in the analysis.
And finally, how are you planning to use this tool to help operators?
Thanks for that question, Clarence. It's very important that, you know, we work with customers who are in this process, journey of network transformation from a vertical stack to an Open RAN, vRAN environment. One of the things that they've been doing is they've been doing lots of proof of concepts and trials primarily to do the technology validation on whether Open RAN, vRAN is something that will work for their network. At the same time, there is this challenge of figuring out whether it commercially makes sense. So operators are building their own TCO models. What we are planning to do is take this, in fact, we're doing this with multiple customers, input their specific network deployment model into our TCO tool, and then help them come up with analysis. In many cases, the way things work is they are trying different network model and they haven't really finalized the final deployment model that they want to launch OpenRAN vRAN at the network. So as they're going through different considerations, we can create models based on those different scenarios that operators want to launch, and then give them the commercial implications and operational efficiencies and TCO advantages between the different scenarios, which we believe is going to really help operators add to their overall TCO and then accelerate the deployment of OpenRAN vRAN networks.
Ravi, thank you so much for your insights today.
Thank you, Clarence. Thanks for having me here.